First look at the forecast. Hi, Audrey.
Hi, Christina. Well, at least we were dry today, which made a difference across the tri-state area. And we also really realized that our March was colder than our February. Here are the average high temperatures for the months of January, February, and March. We were at 38 degrees for the beginning of the year, 41.5 degrees for the month of February. But in March, slightly cooler. Not much of a surprise because we have been experiencing below average temperatures for several days throughout the month. It looks like we are going to finally rise to more normal readings, though, as we go into the upcoming week, and tomorrow we should be breaking into more sunshine across the area. High temperatures, though, below average once again, mostly into the 40s, where normally we should be in the mid-50s, with a high of about 48 degrees in Central Park. Right now we're down to 45 in the park. It's 40 in Islip, 39 out towards Montauk Point. 43 is the number in Bridgeport, and we're in the low 40s in Poughkeepsie and upper 30s up towards Monticello. A look at our satellite and radar shows that the system that brought us all the damp and dreary weather has now pushed off to the northeast here. It did produce a significant snowfall across Boston and into the Cape, but for us it was just cloud cover across the area, and now we're starting to see that break apart, and we should see the sun break through finally tomorrow. Overnight lows will be pretty chilly, mostly in the 30s across the region, and then tomorrow, with more sunshine, we're going for highs into the 50s across much of the tri-state area. I'll have more details coming up. Christina?
Audrey, thank you. So to come, a warning from the White House. Three overflowing rivers. Muddy water and debris crashing into houses. Two bridges were destroyed as well. The Red Cross says that over 200 people are believed to be missing. In addition, President Santos has declared a state of emergency. He's warning that the death toll